Now I think we'll go back to your gestational diabetes.
I want to code 648.8 for gestational diabetes. I do not need a 250 code with the correct with that correct, because 25 code excludes gestational diabetes, right? And she's right. So 648.8 is the code for gestational diabetes. And if you look at 648.80, abnormal glucose tolerance, complicating pregnancy or childbirth, unspecified episode of care. Now, if you go to 250.00, which is your normal type 2 diabetic code, you will see that it has an excludes, and there's an excludes for several things, but I got rid of everything except for gestational diabetes, and it even tells you 648.8 is where you want to go to look for the proper code if it's gestational diabetes. Now, that being said, I went ahead and got some more information on gestational diabetes, because sometimes if you understand the disease process, it will help you to find the codes and to understand that gestational diabetes is nothing like type 1 or type 2 diabetes. It's it is a diabetes that is only when you're pregnant. So they have high blood sugar during pregnancy, and that's it. As soon as the baby's born, it just goes away. And they have found that like 18% of women in their pregnancies get gestational diabetes, and you can have it one time and not have it another. They don't know the cause, but they do know it has something to do with the placenta that supports the baby when it grows, that hormones from the placenta help the baby develop, but these hormones also block the action of the mother's insulin in the body. So this problem is called insulin resistance, and if you have insulin resistant, it makes it hard for the mother's body to use the insulin. So she may need up to she may actually produce three times as much insulin as needed. So gestational diabetes starts when your baby is not able to make and use all the insulin that your body is producing for the baby and the mother. And without enough insulin, the glucose can't be turned into energy. And if you scroll down just a tad bit more, there was a great website that this came from. But ultimately what happens is that that glucose builds up in the blood and it just gets too high and you have hyperglycemia. You can a lot of times just regulate that insulin by diet and exercise, but sometimes you're it's bad enough that you would have to take a medication, take a pill maybe, but there are incidences where women actually have to take insulin injections. I don't know how common that is, but I do know that when they test you and they do that glucose tolerance test, they do it about the time, it's like 20-some weeks, because that's when it usually exhibits itself. And again, as soon as that baby's born, your body goes back to normal, and you may never have problems again. It doesn't matter what size you are. You can be a very thin, healthy, never have had a history of sugar problems in you or your family, or you can be a big person, a big woman, and still, you know, and rather unhealthy, and there, it just doesn't matter. It has more to do with the placenta, and there's nothing as that you can do to stop it either, that it's either going to happen or it's not. So that being said, it is diabetes, but it is a diabetes that comes on and goes in relation to the pregnancy. So it's not coded 250.00. It is actually coded in the 600s.
All right, very good.
And that's a great website down there, by the way. Moving right along.
Yeah, I wanted to go back to this one, just some follow-up questions, if you didn't mind, and then we'll let Boyd merge them together. Sorry, Boyd.
Is that the total, the one, is someone saying something about the third degree? Yeah, I saw that question pop up. Let's see here. If you go and you look up that code, which is the...
What's the question so everyone can know what we're trying to answer here?
Okay, they were wanting to know on the first scenario, if the person has a first degree burn, how come it's being coded in the third degree section? Now, the T21.11 is for first degree, but I think they're talking about the T31.11. And if you go and you look at that code, I think that's a generalized code. They're not saying, they don't have a code for first degree, third degree, and first, second, and third degree. They have it just, let me, I'm going to pull up my book at the same time, or if you can, yeah, you got to tell it to do ICD-10. I really like using Find a Code also. Burns involving... See, it says burns involving 10 to 19% of the body surface area, okay, with 10 to 19% third degree. And it's the way I understand this is it's not saying it has to be third degree, but they're saying that if 10 to 19% is third degree. Now, if you have an ICD-10 and you go look at it, T31, if you go look, and I hope this doesn't make a liar out of me, but if you go and you look at that, there's not a code for body surface for first degree and body surface for third degree. And that's why you're using that code.
All right. And we can come back to this too if
Go ahead. If you do your slide, I will look that up and confirm that. And even if you probably have the same ICD-10 that I do, and I'll give you a page number.
Because I think this digit here is we're supposed to add up the TBSA, the total body surface area, and then the lats digit is supposed to be that is third degree. Or worse, like a deep third or third with loss of body part.
Yeah. If you go and you look at all the T31s, it mentions third degree in every single one of them. So there, it says, it's like 0 to 9% third degree burns. It's inclusive.
Okay.
So yeah, if you go in and you look through T31 through T32.99, you'll see that every single one of those in green have it says with, and then it gives you a TBSA in third degree.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.